As you all are familiar with the chemical nature of the substance, that is the acid, base and salt, right? You know that what is an acid, you know that what is a base, and even you know that what is a salt, right? So now we are taking up or we are starting with the new topic, that is the salt hydrolysis, right? Before we proceed further, before we take this topic, I just want to recall you that you know that how salt is formed. You all know, right? But still, I'll again repeat for you. Salt is formed when acid react with base. When an acid react with base, they result in the formation of salt plus water. Right, and as you know that acid is acidic in nature, base is a basic in nature, obviously, as the name suggests. Then what is the nature of the salt, right? But we often think like that the salt is always neutral in nature. But actually it is not like that. It can be neutral in nature, it can be slightly acidic in nature, and even it can be slightly alkaline in nature, right? Because it totally depends upon that from which acid and from which base it is being formed, right? If we have the strong acid and the strong base, then ultimately we are going to get a salt which will be neutral in nature, because the acid is strong as well as base is strong, right? But if we have either of them is strong and one of them is weak, then ultimately, we are not going to get a neutral salt. We'll get the salt the salt will possess that character which indicates the strongness in the reactant side. That means if it is strong acid and the weak base, that means the salt will have somehow the acidic character in it, right? This is what I'm just going to explain you in this topic, salt hydrolysis, right? So before we start, I'll just repeat a definition for you, because it will be easier for you to just cope up with the topic, right? Actually, salt hydrolysis is a phenomena that in which the salt react with water to give back acid and base. Or you can say it is actually the reverse of neutralization, right? As we know that neutralization is a reaction in which acid and base react to form salt and water, right? It is just this salt hydrolysis is just reverse of a neutralization reaction, because in this the salt react with water, that means the product react among themselves and then just give the reactant, that is the acid and the base. This is called as salt hydrolysis, right? As we all are familiar with this concept too, that whenever we take a salt, suppose I take a salt as Ba, in which B is a positive ion and A is a negative ion, right? Suppose I am taking a salt, we know that the salt ionize completely, they are good electrolytes. That means they just ionize completely when they are present in water, right? Because they are a good electrolyte. Suppose we consider that yes, the salt get hydrolyzed, but the acid and base which are formed, they are not of the same nature. That means one of them is strong and one of them is weak. Like, so for example, I'm taking into consideration the another example. Suppose I have Ba, that is the salt, I am adding it to water, right? So obviously when we add it to water, we are going to get the acid and the base, right? So suppose the base we are getting is BOH and the acid which we are getting is HA, right? You know that how this acid and base is formed, just the reverse of neutralization. Now what I'm considering is, suppose we have one thing is strong and other as weak. Suppose I take it is a strong base and it is a weak acid. Suppose I'm just considering, right? We can have the reaction this type also, that we get a base and acid again, but in this reaction, in contrast to this reaction, suppose we have this is a weak base and this is a strong acid. So that means we can have either of them, right? That we can have that the salt when dissolved in water just form the strong base and the weak acid, or we can have that the salt dissolved in water can give rise to the weak base and the strong acid, right? So if it is a strong base, so this reaction can be just written in this form as well. I can write it in this way also, that Ba plus H2O. As it gives rise to strong base, that means it gets strong base means which completely gets ionized to form hydroxide ions. So this is what I'm indicating with this reaction, that is this all BOH just split to give all its hydroxide ion, but it is a weak acid, so I'm just showing the acid by HA, right? So this kind of the reaction between the salt and the water is called as the anionic hydrolysis. Because in it, which ion get hydrolyzed? The anion get hydrolyzed, right? And in similarly for this case, I can write in reaction, that is we have Ba, that is again salt, dissolved in water, which give rise to a, I said, strong acid. That means they have tendency to get fully dissociated, but we have weak base, so it is like that, right? So in this case, which ion is going to get hydrolyzed? That is the cation. So this salt hydrolysis is divided, just called as the cationic hydrolysis. Right. So I think you've understood what is salt hydrolysis. Again, I'm just repeating for you. You know that what is salt? Yes, salt is something which is formed when acid react with base. Right. What is salt hydrolysis? It's just reverse of the neutralization reaction in which the salt react with water again to give acid and base. Right. It gets completely dissociated. That is why I have put the single arrow that indicates that it is a good electrolyte. Right. So when we dissolve in water, we get, suppose I'm just considering an example, suppose we can have one strong base or a weak acid, we can have a weak base or a strong acid, either of them can occur, or we can also have the base and acid of same nature, that is weak acid, weak base, the strong acid or strong base, right? But in that case, the salt will be neutral in nature. We are going to study about that, how the neutrality of salt can be changed, right? So that is why I am considering an example that here the salt gets dissolved in water and gets break to give strong base and weak acid, and weak base and strong acid, right? So in this case, when it is just going to dissolve in this, so that means that this salt has somehow the alkaline nature because it is formed of strong base. Similarly, this salt is formed of strong acid but weak base, so somehow it has some acidic character in it, right? We'll be taking up in the further topic, but for this instant, I just want to tell you that are you familiar now with anionic hydrolysis and cationic hydrolysis? Yes, you are right. Anionic hydrolysis is something in which we get the strong base and the weak acid. You have to write the equation in this manner. And in case of cationic hydrolysis, we write in this manner, indicating that it is a strong acid but a weak base, right? So I think it is clear that we don't only have the salts which are neutral in nature. We have actually different type of salts. So just let me sum up the different types of salts with examples for you. So different types of salts which we get depending upon which, from which acid and base they are formed. So we can have a salt of strong acid and strong base. We can have a salt of strong acid but weak base. We can have a salt of weak acid and strong base. Similarly, we can have a salt of weak acid and weak base, right? So that means there can be either combination which can take place, and it will result in the formation of, obviously, what will be formed, the product will be same, that is salt. What will be the difference in that? It is just the combinations and the nature of the soil. That means the salt is not neutral or somehow possess the acidic character or some alkaline character, right? So the only difference lies in the nature of the salt, but ultimately after these reactions we are going to get the salt, right? So let us make few examples for it. Suppose strong acid, the acid which is striking in my mind as strong acid is suppose HCl, strong base suppose NaOH. So when they will react, they will form a salt, obviously it will form NaCl. And what will be the nature of this NaCl? Obviously it is going to be neutral in nature because it indicates the strong acid and strong base, that means they totally get neutralized. So that means the salt is neutral in nature, right? Similarly for this, suppose we consider a strong acid, so we say HCl, weak base, the example which is striking in my mind is, let us take calcium hydroxide. We know that calcium hydroxide is a weak base. So which salt we are going to get? CaCl2. So that means this, so now if I ask you that is this CaCl2, this calcium chloride, which is a salt definitely, is acidic, basic or neutral in nature? So is it a neutral salt? No, it is not a neutral salt because it is formed by the combination of strong acid and weak base. That means it possesses somehow the acidic character. It is acidic salt, right? So the salt which is formed by the combination of strong acid and weak base is called as acidic salt, right? So let us now look for the example of, for the third one, weak acid. So let us take the weak acid acetic acid, right? You know that acetic acid is a component of vinegar, right? It is the other name for the vinegar, the IUPAC name for the vinegar, or sorry, the common name for the vinegar. Otherwise, the IUPAC name is ethanoic acid, right? Strong base, let us say NaOH, that is the caustic soda, that is sodium hydroxide. So what they are going to form, they are again going to form definitely a salt, CH3COONa. Now, if I talk about the nature of this sodium acetate, CH3COONa, so what is striking in your mind? Yes, it is not neutral again, because it is formed of weak acid and strong base. That means it is slightly basic, or what we call it, any base when dissolved in water, we call them as alkaline. So that means it possesses somehow the alkaline character. So it is again not neutral, right? Now the fourth one, we have to just think for an example where weak acid and weak base react. So weak acid, suppose again CH3COH, weak base, suppose ammonium hydroxide, they will unite to form a salt that is this. So that means again, what will be the nature of this salt? It will be neither acidic nor basic, it will neutral because it is a weak acid and it is a weak base. But if there is a slight difference between the nature of the acid and base, or we can say that yes, the strength of this weak acid is slightly more than this weak base, so that means it will be slightly acidic, right? And if I say that this weak base is slightly stronger than this weak acid, that means it will going to possess the slightly alkaline nature. Otherwise, if their strength is almost same, that means it is going to be neutral because it is formed of weak acid and weak base. So this is how I just want to explain you this thing, that what actually the salt hydrolysis is, what can be the nature of the salt. It is not neutral always, because most of you often use the word that salt, yes, it is a neutral salt. So it is not like that. It actually depends upon from which acid and base it is formed, right? So it is just the nature of the acid and base which decides the nature of the salt. So, and what if somebody asks you about the anionic hydrolysis, so you just have to mention this equation in which it indicates that it is a strong base but a weak acid, right? And similarly, if somebody asks you for cationic hydrolysis, you need to write this, which indicates that it is a strong acid but a weak base, right? Now, if I ask you to write the hydrolysis constant, as you have seen that hydrolysis occur in this case, right? So if somebody asks you to write for an hydrolysis constant, so how you are going to write? In the similar way we write the ionic product for the water, similarly we wrote the ionization constant for acid. So in a similar way we are going to write the hydrolysis constant expression, right? So suppose I have this salt, I am dissolving in this water, and what I get is BOH and HA, that is the acid and base. Here I am not mentioning that it is a strong acid or a weak base, I am just writing the general expression, right? So that means, so according to the law of chemical equilibrium, if you want to write the equilibrium constant expression, then we will be writing in this way, that is the concentration of product into concentration of reactant. As you can see, these are products, so I have just wrote them, right? Divided by the concentration of the reactant. Right, and we know that H2O is present in excess. So H2O multiplied with this equilibrium constant give rise to hydrolysis constant. So KH is equal to BOH, HA, and the concentration of B. So this is how you are going to write the expression for the hydrolysis constant expression for in case of salt hydrolysis when you get, right? I think it is clear. It is so simple. Just have to write the general equation. Then we know that according to law of chemical equilibrium, we just write the constant equilibrium constant expression. That is the ratio of product to ratio of reactant. If there are certain moles, so just make them as superscripts. And as H2O is present in excess, so we can just multiply it with K, giving rise to KH. And what here this KH stands for? It is hydrolysis constant. So this is how you are going to write for the hydrolysis constant, right? Now the question which you might be asked will be that explain the anionic and cationic hydrolysis. That is the important one, that is the cationic and the anionic hydrolysis. Suppose, now just look at the board, how to do that. Suppose I am writing in hydrolysis for an example, for the weak acid, the salt which is formed of weak acid and strong base. Right, we are going to write three things, we are going to derive three expressions for this. That is, one is the hydrolysis constant value. Other will be the degree of hydrolysis, that is up to what extent it actually get hydrolyzed, right? And the third, we'll look for the pH as well, right? So I'm just taking an example of the salt which is formed of weak acid and strong base. So let it be Ba, right? So Ba plus H2O, we know that it is just going to form BOH plus Ha, you know that, right? I can write this equation in a different manner, that is, which means the same, just the writing, you can say the method of writing is different, right? This I can write in an ionized form. So it is a strong base. So that means we are going to get this, them separated with Ha, right? And we know that this kind of hydrolysis is called as the anionic hydrolysis. As I explained to you, that in this case, anion is going to get hydrolyzed, right? So I can write this equation in a different manner, that is, which again means the same. Because it is a weak acid, so I'm just writing an ionic equilibrium for it, right? So we can write this general reaction in either of the form, right? It means the same, right? So now I'm just going to calculate the hydrolysis constant for this reaction. Either we use this or that, it means the same. If somebody asks you about the anionic hydrolysis, just say that anionic hydrolysis occur only when the salt which we take is formed of weak acid and a strong base, and write either of the reaction, right? So now we are just going to find the value for the hydrolysis constant. So if I write the expression, the KH expression for it, what it is going to be, obviously it is concentration of Ha, concentration of hydroxide ion, and the concentration of this A negative. This H2O we are neglecting because H2O with K gives rise to KH, as I told you in this expression, right? So we get this expression. So I'm just numbering it as first expression, right? So now in a second, we know that the weak acid is always in equilibrium with its ion as well. There is the equilibrium between the ions and the unionized molecule. So similarly, I am writing the ionization constant for this weak acid. Again, the concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. I think it is clear that why I have put this reversible sign here. You know that in case of equilibrium, because it gets partially dissociated, so that means we put the reversible sign. So that is how I have put. So I have numbered this equation as 2. Right. Now, we also know the ionic product of water, that is the H and OH ion. So I am just numbering this equation as 3rd. I think it is clear from where I wrote this, these expressions, you know how to write them. Just write the reaction, then we have the hydrolysis constant expression, as I told you here how to write it. So this I have written for this equation. I can write for this as well, I can write for this as well, means the same, right? So, and as we know that we have the weak acid, that means anion is going to get hydrolyzed. So we are just going to look for the ions which are actually ionized and which is the unionized molecule. So this is what I have wrote an expression for a weak acid. Then we have the ion, you know how to write the ionization constant for an acid, we did in the when we were discussing about the strength of the acid and base. So this is this, right? And we do know the ionic product of water as well. So this is this. So now what we'll do, we'll just multiply the equation 1 and equation 2 and divide by equation 3, right? So this is what I'm doing in the next step. What I'm doing, I'm just multiplying the equation 1 and equation 2. That means I am multiplying the KH into Ka. Right, left hand side multiplied with left hand side, right hand side multiplied with right hand side. So that means Ha OH negative A multiplied with this Ka expression, that is H positive, A negative and HA. Right. And as I told you, we have to divide by equation 3. That means we are dividing with KW. Right. So, there is no space to write here. So, I'll just write an expression again. So, it is, I'm just copying it from this side. As there is less space left. So, in order to make you understand in a better way, I'm just copying it again. Right. So, this is what I wrote in this step. Right. Now, we have to divide it with... Now we have to divide it with the KW, that we have this. So that means 1 upon H positive into OH negative. Right. And what on left hand side, what do we have? We have KH into KA upon KW. I think it's clear this expression. Now we are just going to cancel out the same terms. As I can say, HA just cancels out. This A and A negative ion cancels out. Hydroxide and hydroxide just cancels out. Hydrogen ion with hydrogen ion just cancel out. So that means we are just left with an expression KH into KA upon KW equal to 1. Right. So if I want to have the value for the hydrolysis constant, so I'll just shift them. So we have KH is equal to KW upon KA. So this is the you can say the value for the hydrolysis constant. I think it is clear. Again, I'll repeat for you what I did. As I took the weak acid and the strong base example, I just wrote a reaction to show an ionic hydrolysis. Then I wrote an expression for KH. Then I wrote an expression for the ionization constant for the weak acid. And we know that the ionic product of water is this. What I did, I just multiplied these two equations and divided by this 3. Cancelling out the same one, we are just left with 1. So here we have KH into KA divided by KW is equal to 1, right? So that means here we have the expression, that is the KH is equal to KW divided by KA. So this is how you, if somebody asks you to derive hydrolysis constant, you have to derive in